Good evening, viewers. Thank you for tuning in. My name is, of course, Henry Rudokian, coming to you on the waves of Majesty Christian Television Network. I am positioned this evening to speak the word of life into your life. And I thank you that you've been watching this program, and I am very, very sure that you are also being blessed. Thank you for being a partner, and I am committed to praying for you and your household, and as you continue to listen to this and tuned to Majesty Christian Television Network, your life will never, never be the same. That is my assurance to you. Let's pray. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you for this hour. It is yours. Take it and use it for the glory of your name. May you impact people's life through this channel and let them experience your unusual favor. Let lives be transformed even as your word goes out through the cable lines. This I pray tonight, Lord, in Jesus' name, with thanksgiving. Amen. I'm continuing my message on what I've been preaching for this whole month, and that has to do with living a profitable life. Today, I'm not just only going to talk about what profitable lifestyle is all about, but I want to give some tangible examples of those who have lived profitable lives and how they benefited from it. In other words, when you set your heart to want to do something and you want to contribute to your economy, contribute to your generation, contribute to your family, to your village, be a blessing to others. There is no how God will not reward you. God is not a man and he can never be mocked. The measure upon which you give is the same measure that God will use to give you back and even more. Are you hearing me, somebody? So we have no reason not to live a profitable life, because at the end of the day, we are going to be benefited from that lifestyle which we have lived. So it pays us more to do good than to do evil. A profitable lifestyle is a life that people benefit from the grace of God that is flowing out of your system. The benefit from what you are doing. It can be a talent. It can be your ability to you know, direct people in your leadership. It can be in your communicative skills. The way you are able to impact people positively, and people look onto receiving you, having you, hearing from you, taking you as their role model, taking you as their coach, taking you as the one they want to copy his or her footstep, makes a lot in life. Sometimes it is time consuming. Sometimes it demands a lot. It's like you have no time for yourself. And sometimes it's like you are just giving and giving and giving and giving. And sometimes the devil wants to deceive you to let you think, oh, what you are doing is not recognized. Nobody is seeing it. But somehow along the line, I want you to know that even though many may not receive what you are doing, but there are some that your lifestyle is impacting. And that is why you don't need to give up. There are some that your lifestyle is impacting. You don't need to impact the whole village before you know you have impacted a people's life. Neither do you need to impact 90% of the population before you know. It can just be a fraction of people that are benefiting from what you are doing. Continue to do it. As you continue to do it, you will surely, 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 surely earn a reward out of it. Hallelujah. How far are you impacting your generation? In what way are you living a profitable lifestyle? In what way are you using what God has put in you to be a blessing to other people? It can be your finance. It can be that you have a way, you are very gifted in business, that you can turn a cent into millions. In what way are you using that experience or that talent to be a blessing to your generation? In what way are you using it to help other poor people around you? In what way are you using that to show compassion, to say, hey, this brother have tarried so much in this business and it keeps failing. This sister is not really doing very well in this business. It keeps failing. Let me just go and put an input in what they are doing and show them what I myself did and I became successful. In what way are you not being selfish to the talents and to the giftings of God in your life? In what way are people profiting out of your grace, I want you to examine that today and do something better. In case you are doing already, continue to do. In case you're already impacting people's life, please continue. And in case you are not, and you cannot really pinpoint any person you have impacted his or her life positively, I want you to make a U-turn. That life is not profitable. And I want you to re-advise or revisit your life and ask God to impact you so that you can be a blessing to others. Hallelujah. I want to take my scripture in the Bible and show us tangible examples of people who lived profitable life and how they benefited out of it. That means there is no how you will live a profitable life without benefiting out of it. First and foremost, it gives you satisfaction that you are impacting in the lives of other people. It gives you confidence that you are not a burden to anybody. Do you understand? People will want to have you. They will want to welcome you. You are not a burden. It gives satisfaction. It gives inner feeling. It gives peace within your soul that you have lived a life worthy of emulation. And that prolongs life anyway. That prolongs life. It makes you desirable. It makes you to know that you are not a burden. You are not a problem. You are not a liability. You are adding to the environment. Hallelujah. In the Bible, in the book of Luke chapter 7, let's read from verse 1 to 6. The Bible said, and I read, and he had finished all. He had finished all his saying in the hearing of the people. He entered Capernaum. Now a centurion had a servant who was sick at the point of death, who was highly valued by him. When the centurion heard about Jesus, he sent to him elders of the Jews, asking him to come and heal his servant. And when they came to Jesus, they pleaded with him earnestly, saying, "He is worthy to have you do this for him, for he loves our nation, one, and he is the one who built us our synagogue." And Jesus went with them. Hallelujah. He said, Jesus did not hesitate. The moment he had those two reports, the Bible said, Jesus quickly decided to begin to go with them. So, this is an example of how profitable lifestyle can benefit those who have lived it. He talks about a centurion. He talks about a man who was placed, who already was a leader. He was leading a military, so comprised of many people that are up to 100 or more. So the Bible tells us that this leader had people who were serving him. But in the midst of those who were his servants, there was one that was very, very profitable. The Bible said that this centurion valued this servant. He placed high value on this servant because this servant have excelled above the other servants. And unfortunately, he fell sick. I want you to examine this a little bit. I want you to think about it. That this was a servant to a rich man. He did not just serve the way some of us normally serve. We serve with eye service. We serve with hypocrisy. We serve just while that person is there. And when the person is not there, we don't serve. We become bosses of our own. For the Bible to reckon it that this very servant was highly esteemed by his master means that that was how it is, because the Bible can never lie. So, the fact is that the master profited from his service. The master profited from the giftings in his life. The ability to serve and to serve honorably and to serve with obedience and to serve with all commitment, to serve, you know, being submitted. He didn't serve like a grumbler. He didn't serve like a critic. He didn't serve like somebody who was just rebellious, but he served with humility, served with purity of heart. He served with honesty. He esteemed the business of his master like his own. He didn't see that master far from his own father. He esteemed his business like his own, served that man like he's somebody that came out from his loins. And while the master was profiting out of the grace of humility in his life, he also was profiting out of the grace in the life of this master. Because the Bible said this centurion was a very kind-hearted man. He was too kind and too good, too generous. Actually, he was a philanthropist to the point that he built a whole synagogue, a whole church for the community. So people benefited from the grace in his life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. People tapped into his grace, benefited from his grace, and they spoke well of him. Little wonder, when the servant became sick, it wasn't just something that bothered the master alone. I believe the whole village, they were all bothered. Because the Bible said that this centurion sent forth two leaders. He sent them to go because he had heard that Jesus was around. So he sent forth these leaders to go. He said, please, can you just go and talk on behalf of me? Can you do something? Please, just go and see if Jesus can agree and come. Beloved, I present to you at this moment that Jesus we are talking about, well, it's not that same, it's not the Jesus that goes to every people's home. Any person that the Bible registered that Jesus entered their home was somebody very prominent, somebody very useful, somebody that Jesus wanted to teach, to use to teach a lesson to the world. He doesn't just get up and pack himself and begin to go. I mean, he was such a busy man. He was so crowded by multiple of people that he didn't have too much time going to visit people and eat big, big dinners. So anyone that was fortunate to have Jesus visiting his home must have left a legacy, must have made an impact, must have lived a life profitable to others. Are you hearing me, somebody? Are you hearing me, somebody? So the Bible said this centurion leader sent forth the elders and said, please, you can go and talk while I sit and watch my honorable servant. Let me see. Maybe the grace of God can speak on behalf of me. Behold, when these elders went to Jesus Christ, who had just entered Capernaum, they went and they ran to him. They said, Master, please, we know that you are very, very busy, but we have something very urgent. Please come to us. Quickly, Jesus' attention was got. They not only did they get the attention of Jesus Christ, out of the multitude that had, that had gone out to follow Jesus or to catch a glimpse of Jesus or to want Jesus to heal the sick people who were around them, out of this great multitude, Jesus noticed these elders. Jesus gave ear to these elders. These elders had something which was very unique. They said, there is a man in our village, as a matter of fact, if you do not come now, we don't know what's going to happen. Please, Jesus, come and heal his servant. His servant is highly esteemed. Because this man, we give you a reason why this man is too important to us. This man, he is a noble person. And not only is he noble, he has done a lot in our community. And one of the things he did has to do with building a synagogue for us. He said, this man is being loved by our nation for all that he has done. That means we have benefited out of the grace in his life. We've benefited out of the multiple thousands he has. We have benefited, not only us, but also our children. The whole community have benefited out of the grace in his life. So this man we are saying about has lived a profitable life. Please, Jesus, come to us and let us go together so that you can heal his sick one. Profitable lifestyle. Profitable lifestyle. You know, when you are living a profitable life, it will always speak for you. When the devil wants to hit at the door of your house, something that you have done will speak on behalf of you. Human beings may not be able to see the devil with their eyes, but something will leave heaven to come down to protect you. you. Something will leave heaven to come down on behalf of you. God will just corner somebody who will have an answer to what you need. I just want to present to you, it's very important to live a profitable life than to live a useless life. A profitable lifestyle pays. A profitable life is not regrettable. A profitable life is admirable. It makes one's life being prolonged. It makes the society happy. It gives honor to God and God alone. Live a profitable life. I challenge you and I command you, as you hear the sound of my voice, to make a U-turn. Where you are living a life that is useless, make a U-turn and begin to live a life that is profitable, and then you will become honorable. Hallelujah. You will make your society glad. You will make your family glad. You will make God to know that you are a child that he is proud about. A profitable lifestyle. They beckoned Jesus as they spoke, and they told Jesus, this man is being loved by our whole nation. He is worthy for you to do this kindness for. He is worthy. Can you imagine when the mouth of men can testify for your goodness? Can you imagine when people will begin to speak good? Not that they are speaking evil about you, but they are beginning to speak good and say, hey, as for this person, we know this person for this good. We know this person for this good. This person cannot live a useless lifestyle. Please, sickness, leave this person. Poverty, leave this person. Hey, when you are traveling, you are living a profitable lifestyle. Let me tell you, even when you are living that environment, people are crying. When you are even going for vacation, people are crying because they are wondering, how is it going to be? I remembered when my father was sick. My father was sick. I heard that my father even was in coma for 7 days. And the doctors were almost writing him off. But somehow we continue to pray, we continue to believe. But not only us, the whole community, my whole village, all the churches all around my village gathered, and they were praying for one man. I mean, from morning till evening, people took their turn. Churches took their turn. More than 50 churches, they took their turns and they were praying. This, as these people are finishing, the other people are coming in, they continue to pray. They continue to pray. There were some who could not go to the hospital, but they were praying in our own, in our own house. They will go to that compound and they are praying. Whether the compound is open or not, they stay at the outside. They were praying. They were praying. Some were fasting. And when my father came back, the day my father came back, my father was asking the nurse, where is my file? Oh, where is my file? Where is my file? And the nurse was looking at him. The nurse said, which file? He said, yes, because there was a file. They were just calling my name. And then when I was called, and then they opened my eye and I saw thousands upon thousands. And they were wailing and they were crying. So the man who stood in front of me with white garment told me, look at all the people, how they are crying because of you. Look at how they are crying. They are wailing and they are saying that it's not yet your time. So, Mr., he said, Chief, Nathaniel, go back. The moment that thing, he said, give him back his file and let him go back. Bam. That was how he came back to normal life. That was how his eyes opened. And then he was still very conscious, thinking that he was still there, but he didn't know that he was now being heard physically by the nurse that was attending to him. The nurse said, which file are you talking about, Chief? He said, the file. So it took about 15 minutes before he realized where he was. Before he realized that he was back to earth. Are you hearing me? So when he realized, he began to talk to people around. He said he saw a crowd of people that were lamenting, that were crying, and they were pleading and asking that he had to return back. It was not yet his turn to go. Profitable lifestyle. When you live a profitable lifestyle, even when sickness touches you, people will intercede for you. When any enemy comes around you, people are ready to die on behalf of you because you've lived a profitable lifestyle, or you are living a profitable lifestyle. Don't be selfish when God has blessed you with money. Don't be selfish when God has blessed you with talent. Don't be selfish when God has blessed you with some skills which can impact others. Share those skills profitably. Enjoy in sharing them and watch and see how those kindnesses will make a way for you one day. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I give an example of a lady in the Bible as well that lived a profitable life. In the book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter 9, from verse 36 to 38, the Bible said, "Now there was at Joppa a certain disciple named Tabitha, which by interpretation is called Dorcas. This woman was full of good works and alms deeds, which she did. And it came to pass in those days that she was sick and died, whom when they had washed, they laid her in an upper chamber. And for as much as Lydda was near to Joppa, and the disciples had heard that Peter was there, they sent unto him two men, desiring him that he would not delay to come to them. Then Peter arose and went with them. When he was come, they brought him into the upper chamber, and all the widows stood by him, weeping and shewing the coats and garments which Dorcas made while she was with them." Profitable lifestyle. Profitable lifestyle. Are you seeing this example again? I don't think the Bible wrote these things by accident. It is just for us to know that those who live a profitable lifestyle can also have persecutions. They can also have a time that they are in need. They will also have a time when something will want to quench their life. But then the works that they have done will speak for them. People will arise and people will fight against that thing that have come to want to choke them up. So the Bible told us of a woman as well. Probably you are a woman sitting and looking and watching at this broadcast. God is speaking to you right now. Do not stop in your kindness. Probably that's the only thing you know to do. Do not stop taking care of the orphans around you. Do not stop taking care of the widows around you. Do not stop paying the school fees of those children that you are paying their school fees. Do not stop showing that kindness, because in due time, it will speak on behalf of you. It will surely, surely, surely speak. If sometimes when we do good, we are expecting those we have done the good to be the same people to return the goodness to us. Sometimes we have done good, but the people we have shown this good to become very ungrateful. Let that not hinder you to stop. Let it not stop you to stop doing your kindness. Live a profitable lifestyle. Those that live profitable lifestyle are not sitting down and waiting for those who will reward them. They are not sitting and waiting for those who rejected their kindness, or who usurped their kindness and turned bitter in the midst of their kindness. They don't sit down to count about those who have turned against them in evil and paid them evil in place of good. It can be so bitter, it can be so annoying, but let those things not stop you from doing good. So Dorcas went about doing good. Dorcas is not in the Bible, not because of his wife. He was not in the Bible. She was not in the Bible, not because she was a very good housewife. The Bible didn't even mention about this woman being married. No, but she lived a profitable lifestyle. She lived a profitable. This is for those of you who think you got to be Mrs. before you do something good in your generation. You got to be Mrs. before you use up the money of your husband to help other members. No, you can, out of the grace of God in your life, do something. You can do something. You can impact your generation positively. It doesn't need you to be a Mrs. before you impact your generation positively. Are you hearing me? Because there are some women who lock up themselves and they say, because I'm single, how can I do? I cannot really do it because I'm really single. Oh, when they call, they say, these are the Mrs. of, these are the women who are married to our community. They are the ones showing us kindness here. So those who are single, they go about thinking they have nothing to do. That is nothing but a lie from the pit of hell. You as an individual can impact your generation. You can impact your community. You can do something just like Dorcas did. Hallelujah. The Bible said she spent her time and her substance in giving alms to the poor. He helped those who do not have. He helped the widows. He helped the orphans. He helped the widowers. He helped those who cannot help themselves. She was busy using her talent to be a blessing. She made some garments, sewed some clothes, you know, sent some to school, taught some people, bought some machines and gave to people, taught them how to sew. He did. She did lots of good. The time came, she became sick. And when she became sick, the Bible says she died. And when she died, the people refused to bury him. There are some people, we quickly rush to go and bury them because they are so wicked. They are so wicked that if we don't bury them so fast, they may open up their eyes. So if they are going to open eye, let them open eye inside the grave. Some people will say, let them open up their eye inside the grave. By then, the sun have already covered them. So nobody is there to escalate and to bring them out to life again. Are you hearing me, somebody? Let your wickedness not make people want to bury you so quick. So quick. Let your wickedness not make people, when you pass, they begin to desire that you die. Like a story that is often told, that there is this man whose business has to do with making of coffins and shaping of coffins. So there was this very hard man living in the village. Each time the man passes, the man will come and stand in front of carpenter and ask him, "Oh, how business today?" So one day the man was supposed to ask him, "How can business prosper when people like you are still alive?" The man will say, "How business, brother? How business today?" The carpenter will say, just say, fine, just to get him out of his sight, you know. But this guy will just, you know, be because he's so mean, a man. So he will just laugh hypocritically to that businessman to say, "I go," and he will use it and say, "I go gebugi," means he said, "Hunger will kill you with this your profession." So the man turned one day when he asked, "Hey, how business?" So the carpenter said, "How can you always be asking me of business when you are working? And you are walking. Is it not that you have to die then and they can come and buy coffin from me to bury you?" Let people not speak that about you. Let it not be that you are so wicked, you are so mean, you are so unprofitable that people just want you to get away from their side. But be like Dorcas. Be like the servant of that centurion that they refused to cast aside. They refused. They just washed Dorcas and put Dorcas in an upper room. They said, "Well, we just have to put her there. And we're going to continue to cry. Who knows? Maybe somehow God will divinely come our way." And eventually God heard their cry. Eventually God heard them because Peter, out of nowhere, decided to go to that side. The moment Peter entered that city called Joppa, the people ran to they heard the rumor that Peter had come. And Peter was such a disciple or an apostle that even the shadows of him were healing the sick. Aprons that came out from his body was healing the sick. So they decided, they said, "We will surely do what we can to get to Peter." And some of them, I believe they must have taken their handkerchiefs and take it so that they can just rub it on his body, and they will run back to just go and place it on the body of Dorcas. But before they could figure out what they were going to give to Peter that would make Peter to come, God had gone ahead of them. Now, let me tell you one thing. The good news to anyone that is listening to me right now is that if you are living a profitable lifestyle, that lifestyle will go ahead of you. God will make sure that which wants to terminate your life will not terminate it. God will make sure that which wants to bring a closure to your kindness will never be able to succeed. God will go ahead of you. Your kindness will speak for you. Your profitable lifestyle will speak for you. Your arms will speak for you. If they cannot speak for your generation or speak for you right now, they're going to speak on behalf of your kids. They're going to speak on behalf of your grandchildren. Continue to do good. Hallelujah. Continue. It pays to do good than to do evil. After all, the Bible crowns it by saying, blessed is he that giveth than the one that receiveth. If people make themselves feel and just want you to be sowing in them, go on, baby. Go on, mister. Keep sowing in them. Keep sowing that God does good things that are coming out of your life, and you will see how God one day will reward you. This is what I have for you today. Don't give up in your kindness. Don't ever give up. Can we talk about Cornelius in the book of Acts of the Apostles? For the sake of time, I'm not going to read it. But if you are a good Bible student, you will know that the book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter 10, from verse 1 to 4, talks about a man that was doing good, that was giving alms. He prayed at a particular time. His goodness became so heavy that it became a memorial in the sight of God. And one day, God sent for angelic visitation just to go and tell him, Cornelius, your giving has become a memorial in the sight of God. Your goodness, your profitable lifestyle have become a memorial. Can God speak about that, about you? Can God send for angelic hosts on behalf of you? Oh, my person who is listening to me, I pray that Jehovah will release angelic visitation on behalf of you. Let your kindness gather more momentum. Let it gather. Let it gather. Let it gather. And one day, angelic hosts will come to you. They will come and knock at the door, and they will tell you, heaven sent us on behalf of you. You can be assured that when heaven will look down and find you profitable, and they will dispatch an escort on behalf of you, it will be for gold. They will bring good news. They will bring good news. They will bring good news. They will surely, surely, surely bring good news. Don't give up, and do not envy the wicked who refuse to share their talents. Do not envy them. They are already doomed into destruction. But you that is listening to me, for a purpose you have turned to this broadcast, is because you are living a profitable lifestyle and God wants you to continue. May his grace be sufficiently enough for you as you continue to carry out that wonderful things that you are doing for the body and as well for humanity. God richly, richly bless you. May you not lack anything good. May it continue, may Jehovah continue to supply unto you and add more and more unto you from grace to grace to grace. In Jesus' mighty name, I pronounce this over you. Receive it in Jesus' name. It will be well and it will continue to be well with you and your household. And don't give up. Hallelujah. 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 I thank God for your life. And I want you to know, viewers, that we need you to support the channel. We need you to stand with us. We need some equipment to buy. Please, just go to our website, www.majestytv.org. Look down. You will see how you can sow some seed, how you can support this work of God to continue to go globally. And as you do that, God will richly, richly bless you. May we, Majesty Television crew, profit from the blessings of God in your life, just like you're also profiting out of the blessings of God in our own life. Be blessed and bye for now. See you again next week.